A new ripoff in Better Body Products. The exclusive story at 11.
The following ABC News special contains words and pictures that may be unsuitable for young children. Viewer discretion is advised.
Live in West Palm Beach, I'll have the story of the Kennedy rape case tonight.
I guess tragically for mankind and womankind, this is the perfect cocktail. Sex, brutality.
Money, power, sex, crime, anger, hate.
Good. All right, thank you very much.
It turned into a public contest, and a lot of us were interested.
Okay, are you coming downstairs here?
We were interested, first of all, in the man. Had it not been for him and his name, we wouldn't have been there. Now, a year after that encounter on the beach, we want to know about all men. At the beginning of a year of sex gone wrong and men on trial, William Kennedy Smith was found not guilty of rape. We came back to Palm Beach County not to report the Smith case again, but to look at some of the other cases here that didn't make the news. We came because something is happening between men and women that cannot be understood from any one encounter. Tonight, we're particularly interested in listening to men and talking to men, to us, about rape. Do we understand what rape is? Do we know what women fear and distrust in us? Why do we think and act the way we sometimes do?
Watched her inside, and he waited. He had picked his victim out prior to committing the crime.
I can't remember him as a human being. It's like an animal. It's not a person. It's an animal.
To learn about rape, we must consider this. Men on the street do not see the other half of the population as a potential physical threat. Most women do.
In our society, women tend to be victims, men tend to be pursuers.
I had a guy several weeks ago in a van pull over to the side of the road and ask me if I needed a ride. My first reaction was, no, I don't need a ride, bleep, bleep. What does it look like I'm doing? I don't need a ride. Get the out of here.
When you have looked at all the photographs, tell me whether or not you see the person that committed the crime.
This is the guy right here.
Okay.
This one.
Some of us think we know what rape is. Many women think we do not. Where does the idea of rape begin? Are male rituals such as the bachelor party completely unrelated? Or is there a link between what goes on here with a woman's consent and what happens in the mind of another kind of man, one who forces sex without consent? It didn't take a famous rape trial to get Palm Beach thinking about the difference between the sexes. Here, you cannot help but notice. Palm Beach is deep in the Sun Belt. There are fewer clothes here and fewer inhibitions. Does this mean rape is more likely here? No. Sex can turn violent anywhere, regardless of the climate or the clothing or the look or the age of the women. The crucial element is the behavior of men. Women and men have never been more open and integrated at work and at play than they are today. And the reports of rape keep increasing at a higher rate than other violent crimes. Some of us say it's only poor communication, that men and women have different expectations. What do men expect from women? And why?
We need to focus on men in general. We need to look at the whole way that we are socializing our children, especially our boys, about being responsible about sexuality, about being responsible about their own anger. Because I think, you know, at a real fundamental level, rape is about anger and sex.
What's the most obvious manifestation of that anger?
What's the most hostile thing you can say to somebody? If you want to spit on somebody verbally, if you want to be as vituperative as you can imagine, what you will say to them is, "You." And what that says is that sex and aggression are fused in this culture. And when somebody says, "Screw you, Jack," and means it, you know what they mean. And what they mean is, "I will hurt you. I want to hurt you."
Girls know what that little game that goes on said between people. Whereas if you give and give and give, that in back in at the end, it's going to come back to you. And they know, and they try to be cute about it. And some guys will just walk away and say, you know, they got burned, you know, and they're good about it. But there'll be those few in the crowd that are going to say, you know, "Not me. You know, you can play that kind of thing on somebody else, but you're not going to get away with me, and you are going to pay for the good time you had."
I don't think it's a crime of sex. It's anger. It's power. They feel that they want that power. I know in my case it wasn't. At first the initial thought was the sexuality of it. But it went way beyond that before I ever touched that woman. It went way beyond that.
"If you don't do what I said, I'm going to kill you right then." That's the control. That's the biggest fear, right? The first thing they think, "Don't kill me, don't kill me." And see, when you're doing that, you're getting off on it. Yeah. I mean, that's when that other thing, "She's mine now." You know, I go ahead and I do what I got to do, and ain't nothing she can do about it.
Rape is nothing new. Rape has been going on for thousands and thousands and thousands of years. They say prostitution is the oldest profession in the world. Well, the first guy that didn't pay started rape.
Peter Jennings reporting, Men, Sex, and Rape. Brought to you by Lincoln, What a Luxury Car Should Be.
Alpine Lace Free and Lean, fat-free and low-cholesterol singles made with real cheese.
"You mean I can eat cheese products again?"
New Free and Lean.
Be in great shape, America, with Alpine Lace.
For the past year, you've been hearing about a long-distance savings plan from MCI called Friends and Family. Now that same kind of savings plan is available for small businesses. Introducing MCI's Friends of the Firm. Now, whenever one MCI small business customer calls another in their circle of calls, they'll save an extra 20%. So if you have a small business, start saving an extra 20% right away by making this call.
When you want a hot meal without a big deal, what are you gonna pick?
Hot Pockets!
Hot Pockets, filled with pepperoni pizza or ham and cheese in a crispy pocket. Try Lean Pockets, too.
What are you gonna pick?
You've got a backstage pass for an intimate behind-the-scenes look at one of today's hottest stars.
I love to look out there and see people
enjoying themselves.
Join Whitney Houston and her special guest, Kevin Costner.
I mean, this is a world-class woman.
Whitney Houston, This Is My Life, Wednesday.
When Patricia Bowman accused William Smith of raping her at the Kennedy estate at 3 o'clock in the morning, we often heard people say, if it did happen, she asked for it. Well, that's not the opinion of most researchers who've studied sexual assault. The opinion of every expert we've read and interviewed is that women do not cause men to rape them. Not by what they wear or what they say or how late they stay. The modern view is that the miscommunication that men describe, she really meant yes, is only an excuse to hide the obvious. Forced sex originates in the minds of men. But even for those who've come to believe that, the difficulty is finding out exactly how it originates.
When you come in to a place like ours, you pay your $3 and you come in, you're there to talk to girls, to experience sex. You're not going to get sex, but it's the fantasy you're living. Just like when you read Playboy, when you open it and you read it, it's a fantasy world. It's like Disney World.
A lot of men know what goes on in topless bars. They exist in almost every American city. But why is this fantasy needed? Is it only sexual? Or is there a need to feel women know their place and men are in control?
What do you think, guys? Nice view down there, huh?
Most of our dancers have said they feel safer in here than when they are done work and go home, get dressed, go out with their husband and boyfriend, and they go to a regular bar, and the first thing that happens is 17 men are hitting on them, trying to pick them up. That is the bar scene nowadays. It don't happen here because the men come in here with a different idea in mind. They know they're not going to pick up the girls. They know they're not going to have dates with them or leave. They just come in to enjoy a fantasy. And then they probably go to the all bar and pick up girls. Who knows? And that's when the trouble starts. Or maybe they should have came here instead of going there.
Did you make love last week?
At T's Topless Lounge, the boundaries are clear.
Did you make love?
But at O-Bar, there is more uncertainty about what is expected. The Patricia Bowman, Willie Smith encounter that began here and led to the courtroom was surely not the only incidents of unhappy sex to originate at a bar last year. There was a lot of confusion in such a sexually charged atmosphere. One that seems to bring so much pleasure, but so often leaves men and women asking later, what went wrong?
But I mean, nowadays, what is rape? You pick up a girl in a bar and you take her home and you have some form of sexual expression and all of a sudden she jumps up and yells rape? I mean, give me a break.
One of the real problems is this issue of how defensive men get about this. They feel somehow that they're being accused, even if they are among the majority of men, who aren't sexually violent. And I think it's because all men have some, again, connection to that definition of masculinity, of sex as power and sex as a way of measuring your masculinity.
A lot of people, if I take a girl out or whatever, you know, they ask me, hey, did you score, you know? What did y'all do? They usually want to get into the intimate, you know, they want to know what went on.
Honest answer, did you come here tonight looking for girls?
Yeah, see what was here, you know, see what's happening.
Most of them fear rejection, fear that point of coming on to the girl, you might buy her a couple of drinks, she talks to you, have a good time, and whether you go back to her place or your place, things might get intimate, but then there's a point where she might say, well, you know, I think we should go on, but that fear of rejection, I think, is what pushes that man overboard. He's like, oh, I'm going to be the dominant one. I'm going to be the conqueror. I've come this far. I'm not going to turn back.
Who's that knocking on the door? Gotta be a woman.
Part of getting together is showing off, and no one wants that to stop. Play is important to the survival of the species. When children are growing up, however, we adults don't talk to them much about good sex and bad sex. We mostly leave boys and girls to learn for themselves. And that has left women between 16 and 24, the age group most often raped.
I love you, honey.
That's one of the few statistics we can trust. No one knows exactly how many men have forced women into sex against their will. It is difficult to get honest answers. What we do know is that females of all ages are more willing than ever to say, force cannot be excused as boys will be boys. It is now called rape. It was called rape last year at a high school party at this motel near the beach.
Well, he started getting real rowdy and he left and I went out because I was worried about him to try to calm him down. And then, you know, we were by ourselves.
She had walked up to this enclosure door and Billy Fagan was inside. Shortly after she started speaking with him, he pulled her in, pulled her back behind the dumpster, and pulled her down on the concrete here. This is where the sexual battery occurred.
This is all based on her testimony?
It's based on her testimony as well as two witnesses that walked out from the party after she hadn't returned for about 10 minutes. They got concerned, and they walked back here and found the sexual battery occurring. He was actually in the process of raping her, according to the testimony they gave me.
He was on top and had my hands pinned. And he was a lot stronger than me.
Billy Fagan was arrested within hours of the alleged attack on Stacy Newman. He pleaded innocent and was released on bail.
Coming through.
Billy, stand to the side.
He did nothing wrong.
Stacy knows Billy well. They went to the same high school.
Billy, you convinced you're innocent?
In more than half of all rape complaints, the woman says the man was someone she knew.
I was used to the type of kid, nice, you know, outgoing, fun to be with, you know. He just totally changed. Scary, you know, violent. It wasn't the same kid I thought I knew.
Stacy Newman decided not to try proving her case in court. Fewer than 10% of all rape cases go to trial. In Stacy's case, a plea bargain was agreed to. She never had to try persuading a jury she said no and meant it. Billy Fagan pleaded guilty to battery, not sexual battery. Stacy has scratched out his picture from her yearbook and has dropped out of school. Aside from the pain that Billy inflicted on Stacy, there is confusion that won't go away either. If she wants to grow up being attractive to boys, does she always risk attracting one who needs control over someone who is physically weaker? It is a question some of her classmates have thought about.
I think we've all been in a situation where sometimes we wonder if we pushed a little too hard or, you know, maybe went a little too far. And yeah, I know I've been there where just the thoughts in your mind, well, maybe we went too far. Maybe I talked her into something she didn't really want to do, something like that. So yeah, I've felt like that before. I think everyone really has, you know, a combination of drinking and peer pressure. A lot of things happen that probably shouldn't happen.
What do rapists have in common with the rest of us?
Probably have much more in common than they do different. I think that's part of what we can start with, is that particularly, again, for hidden rapists, the men who rape women in a context where they're unlikely to be detected, that is, in a romantic context, an acquaintance context, a non-stranger context.
What's the difference between acquaintance rape and stranger rape?
In a fundamental way, not a lot.
Stranger rape is a term that has just come about because of this date rape, acquaintance rape, however you want to call it. Rape is rape. I mean, there's not two sections here. But granted, you may not know the victim, and maybe you do know the victim, but forcible sex is forcible sex. And a person who commits a date rape or a stranger rape has the same psychological problems. They're two in the same. Except he picks his prey differently.
Michael Ford was arrested after a series of assaults in one Palm Beach County neighborhood. In a plea bargain, he confessed to raping 8 women and was given a sentence that will keep him in prison for 8 years. He told us he committed one rape in the course of a robbery.
And then I got the money out of her purse and put it in my pocket. And then when I pulled up the bedclothes, the bed sheets, which revealed most of her, she was sleeping only in her underwear. And I looked back down, and that's when the thought hit my mind.
I believe that he did a lot of night prowling to gather the information, or, you know, to find out what he needed to know to feel comfortable about doing the rape. In talking to his wife, or his ex-wife after the arrest, she told me that Mike Ford would often go out late at night for no other reason than he just couldn't sleep and he wanted to go out and smoke a cigarette. Generally, I think he just walked around the neighborhood and enjoying the cool breeze and looking in the windows, see what's happening. Spot somebody that would spark his interest and then he'd act on it.
I remember flipping over onto my back and I started to fight. I was kicking and I started screaming, and I made contact on several of my kicks, and all it did was anger him. He quickly regained control of the situation. He took his knife and grabbed my arms and flipped me back over on my stomach and put a pillow over my head and held it down as tight as he could to try to calm me down.
I believe that all men fantasize about raping a woman, whether it be grabbing her on the street and throwing in bushes or breaking into her house. And the fantasies is the sexuality aspect of it. You keep thinking about it and thinking about it. Maybe you use it as a stimulation and masturbation. And the fantasize, there's nothing wrong with fantasy. It's healthy. It's when you cross that line and you go from fantasy to insanity. And I crossed that line.
He occasionally, which was rather ironic, would he'd allow me to breathe, and he'd take his hand and lift up a little corner of the pillow and he'd brush his hand across my face each of those times.
At times he'd try to romanticize it. He'd say, I want you to come. I want you to, enjoy this. I bet you really want to do this. Things of this nature. He was having a relationship when he was doing this, and in his mind. He was, to him, this was a woman that wanted him. He wasn't raping anybody, as far as he was concerned.
You know, and the fantasies are supposed to like it, you know. Supposed to give you the phone number or something, come on back. It's nothing at all of the way I fantasized it.
How much has rape got to do with sex? How much to do with power over women? And how much to do with anger about women?
As I have come to see it now, for acquaintance rapists, okay, I think there is a lot about the sex. I mean, they want to get laid, as they will tell you. And that's, and their own sense of it is that's what they're doing, okay? As you move toward the serial rapist, okay, it's more and more likely that sex has less and less to do with it, that it becomes more and more involved in their own particular psychological makeup. It turns out that, for example, men who are involved in these very brutal serial rapes tend to be men who were victimized as children and who carry this burden of rage that has become focused on women. You see that less so with acquaintance rapists, who are more sort of victims of their culture, where they've been told it's okay for boys to do this, that this is what a real man should do. Real men don't take no. And it's okay to inhibit your own empathic responding with a woman. That's okay. So that the answer of it depends on the kind of rape, on the kind of context in which it occurs.
When I got arrested for this, people were shocked. No one could believe it. I had a beautiful girlfriend, I had a lovely ex-wife, a beautiful son. I'm the same as you. There's in every aspect, except for that one, to where I went and acted out my fantasies, and where you may not.
Some of you lucky people are getting new calling cards from AT&T. There's just one little hitch. That easy-to-remember card number you've always had? It's history. But don't worry, you can still have a card with your home number plus 4 digits. The new phone card from Sprint. Call now, and it even comes with 100 minutes free. So, which phone company's calling card would you rather have now?
I teach archery, so I always have to hit my target. Thanks to the always-on-target Hearts 2-in-1 team, ridding bow of fleas and ticks is easy and just as accurate. First, use Hearts 2-in-1 Rid Flea Shampoo. It kills fleas and ticks, leaving him really clean. Then a Hearts 2-in-1 collar for up to 5 months of long-lasting protection. The Hearts team, 2-in-1 Rid Flea Shampoo and the 2-in-1 collar. Targets and kills your pet's fleas and ticks. They really work. Hearts, everything good for your pet.
Look at these red marks. These old glasses do nothing but pinch. They're a pain.
You don't have to put up with glasses that don't fit anymore.
Now LensCrafters brings you better fit for greater comfort. LensCrafters glasses fit your snug points with features like new self-adjusting snug fit pads that flex to gently and securely hug your nose.
No more pinching. I never knew glasses could be this comfortable.
LensCrafters. Better fit for greater comfort. In about an hour.
Refreshing Lipton iced tea. Share the experience.
Peter Jennings reporting. Men, sex, and rape will continue in a moment.
Sexual harassment on the job.
Has my boss ever done anything to you guys?
It's his word.
He's told people you had an affair.
Against yours.
Jack French has been coming on to me.
Is this how you'd handle a guy who comes on too strong?
Stephanie Zimbalist, Sexual Advances Sunday.
Diva Industries, one moment, please. Yes, Mr. Hummer.
As far as you misplaced the Peabody file.
But, Mr. Hummer, I placed it on your desk.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
For all the ridiculous incompetence, Miss Bronze, I did what I cannot close the deal.
If it's out there, it's in here. The 9X Yellow Pages. Why would anyone need another?
This is a Channel 7 Eyewitness News Brief.
Good evening, I'm Bill Butel. Tonight at 11, more trouble for the Los Angeles Police Department. This amateur videotape shows cops confronting mobs and then fleeing the scene. In an exclusive report, we'll show you why that may have been a deadly mistake. And you don't cook with this hot sauce. It's an over-the-counter fitness drug. In an exclusive report, see why many of these products are strong on sales and weak on results. And you might not believe your eyes when our hidden cameras capture city tow trucks taking you and your car for a ride and a rip-off tonight at 11.
Light FM, a great radio station that's sounding even better. A bigger, brighter choice of music, but the mood is still light.
WLTW.
call it our pervert file, or our pervert book. And what it is, it's a book of different subjects that have been either arrested for various sex crimes or brought in and questioned and photographed because they were suspected of various sex crimes. There's one person here that pulled the victim from her bicycle and drug her into an alley and sexually assaulted her vaginally. Then we have another one here who says that he prefers women who dress in white, and he sits in his truck, and when they come by, he opens his door and they can see him masturbating.
The assailant was armed with a pistol.
It is hard to identify the rapist until he has raped. In Palm Beach County, police spend an enormous amount of time trying to catch them after the fact.
If you want, I'll go out and re-interview her. Maybe yep. She'll open up. Do you have anything DNA on that that's worthwhile sending away for DNA?
No. The perpetrator didn't ejaculate at all.
Last year, there was the William Kennedy Smith case and 1,000 other cases of alleged sexual assault. Police think many times that number were not reported. The system must deal with an enormous range of deviant sexual behavior.
Unlawfully commit sexual battery upon a person 12 years of age or older without her consent by penetrating or having contact with the vagina of Ms. Knowles with the defendant's penis.
You can see the confusion over how to handle these men by the arbitrary way they are classified after they're caught. There is one set of laws if they rape females over the age of 12, another set if they attack girls under 12. In one West Palm Beach neighborhood last year, a man changed the life of a 10-year-old girl. He was a trusted friend of the family.
He used to pick on Brooke a lot, and by picking on, I mean he used to play with her, you know. But I thought, no, London, this man would never, ever harm your child. He has grown children. He has a grandchild. He would never, ever harm her. So I said, no way.
He was like a dad to me. Because I had problems with my stepdad. And I didn't really have a father, you know, because my father died. And then he was like a father. I'm just scared that it would happen again. And that somehow, sometimes when people look at me funny and look, you know, a man, and that, you know, I would get this tingly feeling, and I would tell myself, Brooke, don't think about it, you know. When we're coming back from our trip, I would say, don't think about it. And with these days, you know, I haven't been thinking about it lately.
Her body has been violated, and she has been scarred. And I know it's not fair to distrust all men, but I know I will be. I am right now, and I know I will be, because I don't want this to happen again.
Linda Hilton went to court to hear the man admit he molested her daughter. He didn't go to jail. He wasn't fined. He suggested counseling, and that's what he got. Sometimes counseling helps the rest of us understand what goes on in a rapist's mind. David McCutcheon had 2 years of therapy during the 3 years he spent in prison. David McCutcheon's fantasy turned fact when he was a teenager. He and a gang of friends began assaulting young girls. He later committed, he says, at least 15 rapes on his own. He was convicted of one. The time he stalked a friend of a friend.
I went on a porch and knocked on a door. And there was nobody at home, so the door was open. You know, pulled to. And so I went in. And I went in the kitchen. Got a knife. And I waited in the attic. And then I got out of the attic, you know, and I thought things were clear. Then I waited behind the door. And when I waited behind the door, she finally came in. So after she finally came in, I waited a little longer, made sure she was asleep. Then when I thought she was asleep, I made my move. I mean, it's like I raped her. And even after that, I still, you know, I had no feelings. I ran out the house, played like everything was cool. There was nothing wrong. And even when I got arrested, I took a polygraph test. I failed it, but I still denied it.
While he was in treatment in prison, David McCutcheon talked with therapists about the one thing he did not like women to do.
Tease. You know, biggest thing I hate for a woman to tease, you know, like lead me on. See, when a woman lead me on, then I get rejected. Back then, when I used to get rejected, that was the biggest thing. I couldn't. That's what started all, really. Rejection. I wanted to be accepted. I wanted somebody to look up to me, be somebody. Hey. And that was the bottom line. But when they said no and reject me, then it's like there was a whiff of anger get up in my adrenaline got out the floor. Whether you say yes or no, I don't care. If you say no, it might as well be a yes, because it's yes to me, because I'm going to make it happen.
David McCutcheon's story is familiar. His violence took a sexual form because he needed to dominate women, and he thought sex was the way to do it.
In other words, the whole biggest thing is degrading. You degrade her until she get to the point where she feel, you know, low. In other words, I use the thing now that I think about it called manipulation. See, I would get her to think it's her fault. What did I do to cause this? And really, it's my fault.
The most difficult to understand is trying to pin down a reason as to why they behave the way they do.
Rene Centeno is a probation officer who keeps track of rapists and other sex offenders. He's also a man trying to understand other men.
No, he's at work.
He's at work? Maybe it deals with the way society tends to view women.
Good meeting you. Take care.
Hopefully used to view women, but many times in their minds they still view women as the weaker sex. Some of the reasonings that they use are rather scary. They may tend to think that because a woman was dressed a certain way, that simply meant that they wanted it. Or a woman walked a certain way, the same thing. Something will click in their mind that will not click in yours or ours.
Mark.
Yes.
How's it going?
All right.
What's going on, man? Who's your immediate boss on the job now?
Randy Taylor.
Randy Taylor?
Uh-huh.
Was he the one I spoke to last time?
No, I believe he spoke to his secretary, Debbie.
As interested as he is in why they do what they do, the system only wants Rennie Centeno to keep an eye on the sex offenders.
Many of these individuals had terrible childhoods. However, that cannot be used as an excuse.
How's it going?
Pretty good, how are you?
John home?
No, he's not home right now.
He's not? Where's he at? I can never seem to catch him at home.
When they look at me and say, I may have done something last night, and it's because of my childhood, sorry. Violation time.
On the night we went with him on his rounds, Rennie Centeno checked in on six offenders. Four of them were somewhere else.
The sexual activity with a child charge, lewd assault charge, lewd act charge, you have a right.
There continues to be a far greater emphasis on punishing sex offenders than on trying to change their behavior so they will not offend again. More than 50% of sex offenders will be arrested again. In Florida, a rapist headed for prison cannot expect much help from a therapist. The state legislature decided in 1989 to stop funding treatment because it's very expensive and because no one is sure that it works.
I am not aware of any treatment approach which has been proven to be effective in treating, in successfully treating persons who are known as rapists.
Dr. Hall's dilemma is common to every prison system in the country. Try as they will to design a treatment program for the many men who rape, if it works at all, it only works over a lengthy period of time and when the rapist is highly motivated to change. Moreover, that sort of effort can double the cost of keeping an inmate in prison. No state has been eager to do that. So here's another crucial question, and it's one that women often ask. If rapists threatened men, would there be more trials, longer sentences, more time and money spent on treatment? And even if it's too late to change a rapist in prison, shouldn't we be trying to learn from them about patterns of behavior? Instead, here's the situation. Few trials, short sentences, little treatment, and a lot of wishful thinking that rapists can somehow learn to control themselves.
See, it's like certain warning signs. When a person commit a sex, it's like he do not put himself in a set-up situation. One-on-one with any woman. That's why when I go places, I let my mom know where I'm at. I let somebody know where I'm at. I'm around two or three people. If there's women involved, I'm around a bunch of guys. That way, they know I don't put myself in a set-up situation. Because even people say, well, they'll cure. You never really cure. Anytime, anything can reoccur or can get, the best thing you try to do is to fight it, to keep it from coming back up again. And see, that's where a lot of people distort things because they say, well, I'm cured. And really, there's no cure to nothing.
Both driver and passenger side airbags. One of them is a Lincoln. And the other one is a Lincoln. With Lincoln, it's easy to be on the safe side. Lincoln, what a luxury car should be.
We asked Maureen Waldron why she switched from Murphy Oil Soap to Pledge Household Cleaner.
There is a big difference. I don't have time to put into rinsing my house. But with the Pledge Household Cleaner, I didn't have to rinse it off. It's just a smooth, clean feeling. So if I can cut out 20 minutes with Pledge Household Cleaner, then that's an additional 20 minutes I can spend with my baby, which is important.
Pledge Household Cleaner gently cleans all your household surfaces beautifully. From S.C. Johnson Wax.
It's going to be Pledge.
When you want a hot meal without a big deal, what are you going to pick?
Hot Pockets, filled with pepperoni pizza or ham and cheese in a crispy pocket. Try Lean Pockets, too.
What are you gonna pick? Hot Pockets.
I'm not exactly known for being subtle, so I told Sprint the phone card had too many complicated numbers. Well, they fixed that. The new phone card has fewer numbers to dial, and the card number is even based on my home number. So now it's a lot easier to use. Of course, they'll probably say it was all their idea.
At last, Alpine Lace Free and Lean, fat-free and low-cholesterol singles made with real cheese.
Fat-free? Like me? Beautiful.
New Free and Lean.
Reshape America with Alpine Lace.
It's us and them.
They left their families and kissed child support goodbye.
You haven't seen me in how many years?
I don't care if I ever see you again.
Deadbeat dad.
She's just taking her heart and twisting it.
Primetime's hidden cameras track them down Thursday.
Burning. Searing.
Now you think I was having a heart attack.
But for millions, it's heartburn. How you can put out the flames on 2020 Friday.
They say it doesn't really do much good, but I walk with my keys in my hand, and I try and act very confident, like I know what's going on around me, and I look. You know, a lot of women walk with their head down, and I just think that's kind of stupid, especially in a mall parking lot. You know, we try and walk out with other people that work here, but you can't always do that. You know, if you've got someplace you got to go, and you know, we call for security sometimes, but you know, sometimes you just brave it and you walk out, and I just act like I own the world when I go out there, and I just make sure I know who's around me, and I'm looking around all the time, and make sure I look in the back seat before I get in, I lock my car door before I get in, that kind of thing.
Most men are comfortably unaware of the threat that women have learned to live with. We men mostly go where we please. Although violent crime affects men, we have no reason to feel threatened by 50% of the population. The increase in rape has coincided with women leaving the home and entering a world that has always been dominated by men. Women are everywhere now.
I was walking along with my hair in a ponytail, fully dressed, no makeup on, minding my own business, walking like I had a purpose, and that's someone came up behind me.
Angela Johnson is a flight attendant who was on a layover in West Palm Beach. A man who may have watched her work out at this health spa followed her when she left. As she walked back to her hotel along this road at sunset, the man grabbed her from behind, put a knife to her throat, and dragged her down on the canal bank. When Angela Johnson came back to West Palm Beach to help the police investigation, her boyfriend came with her so she wouldn't have to travel alone. It was one of the rapes in Palm Beach County last year that didn't make the news.
Can I?
Mm-hmm.
The man who attacked her has not yet paid for his crime. He is every woman's nightmare.
He entered her orally, not vaginally, but did make contact vaginally to the outside, but never entered. Kept wanting her to do different things. She kept gagging and just trying to talk her way out of it. Every time he would try to enter her, she'd say, "Listen, there's something wrong with me here. I don't know what it is. The doctor says there's something wrong. My boyfriend gave me something." She was very smart.
And even I remember thinking, if I could just see his face, and he would cover up my face and I would pull it down. He would cover it up and I would pull it down, and it went back and forth. Your face in the mud, you can't scream too loud. Or a knife at your throat, a knife at your throat and your face in the mud and a knee on your back, you're not going to scream too loud and you're not going to go too far. After he finished doing what he was doing, he was going to leave. He told me to count to 100, and then he told me he wasn't going to kill me, and it was really strange. I mean, he was back to a person again. I mean, he was, of course, I don't know how he was before, but I mean, it's just really sick. I mean, I remember bugs crawling on me and he was trying to get them off. And I'm thinking, just get out of here. Just leave.
And she called me and we were both crying. And she told me she was all right. That, she, just a little bit. I just wanted to make sure she was all right. I tried to remain calm as I could to just check and make sure she was all right. And then after that, it was raining that night. I took off my car and just started driving around. And one of my first thoughts was, what can I do to help her when she gets home? Because she said she'd be home the next day.
Would you like to see colored pictures of him?
Yeah, but I think I know.
Physically, you didn't see anything wrong with her other than the skin knee. But what took place inside of her, I've learned since then, it's just amazing how deep this guy is. He's taken something deep from her as well as me.
I mean, I could be wrong.
I think I'll get it back, but you don't know how much. There's still that doubt in your head, how much you can get back.
One is, I think rape is the kind of crime that should carry a more severe penalty. Sort of like what they do in third world countries. In my belief, there's no reason why a woman, no matter how a man may think about it, should be treated like an animal. And I think when you commit a crime like this, you're treating a woman like an animal.
It is interesting that the men who feel most strongly about rape are those who've seen firsthand what rapists do. The boyfriends, the husbands, the police, the prison psychologists.
Women are often viewed as objects, and part of our socialization process encourages that kind of view or that kind of perception of women on the part of men. Many men are not generally taught the responsibilities that go along with appropriate interpersonal interaction, appropriate sexuality. Appropriate expression of anger. Many men are not particularly taught to be sensitive.
Okay, so she's giving us her second favorite hobby, David, and that is beach volleyball, right? That is her second favorite hobby.
We are not taught to pay attention to our feelings and pay attention to the personal impact of our decisions and our behavior.
Can we turn around one time and face the door thing?
And that's part of that goes along with the view of women as objects. Not as real people, not as real persons who feel and who can personally experience some trauma from some action or decision made by the particular man involved.
Guys, I look okay. I look all right back there, guys.
You know, I think one of the things that you have to acknowledge at the same time is that the majority of men don't sexually aggress against women. That in our studies, you know, over 50% of the men say they have never sexually aggressed against a woman in any way. But there is this substantial minority of men who have and who do, and who apparently by their own raising are vulnerable to some of the messages that are part of what many people call the rape culture. That is the parts of our society that encourage the victimization of women and encourage the control of women by men and the domination of women by men.
Given the overall relationship between men and women, men superior, women inferior, historically, is there a potential aggressor? Is there a potential rapist in every man?
The penis can be used as a weapon. You know, it can be used for procreation, it can be used for pleasure, but it can also be used as a weapon. And so there is that potential, just like there is a potential to use your fist as a weapon or to shake somebody's hand. And so to that, you know, sort of basic level, yes, but I think the point needs to be made again that for most men, the hand doesn't become a fist and the penis does not become a weapon.
In this hour, we've asked a lot of questions we don't have answers for. We think it's significant that no one seems to have the answers, and that's because so little effort has been made to understand an act that threatens so many. What we do know about rape is as true everywhere as it is here in Palm Beach County. Men who sexually assault women are creating a generation of women on guard. And those other men who tolerate rape, who joke about it, who casually blame the victim, are simply making everything worse. Women are right when they say we haven't taken rape seriously enough. And women are right when they say only men can stop it.
I like men in general. I wouldn't want men not to be on the earth. And some of their behavior is nice. I mean, I like to have doors open for me and stuff, but no, I don't like to be followed. I never liked men to look before. I don't like catcalls. I don't know too many people that do. But now it really makes me mad. I instruct aerobics, and I know before if the guy would look in, it might bother me, but now it really makes me mad because he doesn't know me. He doesn't know who I am inside. I mean, and yes, I do look at men. I mean, every, you know, but your attitude is going to change. I mean, men, I think, become a little bit more disgusting to you. You know, and I hear women, I hear other rape survivors that dislike all men now, or they want to kill all men. And even to that other woman, I might say, you hate men that much. Do those men hate us? Do those men hate women that much? You know, I mean, you would have to hate someone to do something this horrible, this disgusting, and this awful to them. You would really have to have a lot of hate.
When I won't go out with a guy by myself. When I see a guy, I think, can he do it? Or would he do it?
I was happy. I wasn't scared as much. I was, you know, I felt like a child, you know. And I knew I could go somewhere and play, you know, don't worry about it. But now, I have to worry about it. Make sure it doesn't happen again.
I'm not just lazy. I'm tired. And so's Barney. Ever since we joined MCI Friends and Family to get the extra 20% savings,
AT&T keeps hassling us to come back. It's not worth it. The savings they promised are off their own higher rates.
Come on. I might be lazy, but I got better things to do than sit around and listen to AT&T. Minutes ago.
Many believe it was the innovative spirit of Europe that inspired him. And when Mr. Ford came home, he created Lincoln Continental. Today, with computerized suspension, electronic transmission, and anti-lock brakes, Continental is one of the most advanced automobiles in the world. Lincoln Continental. What a luxury car should be.
Potpourri! But we're more than just potpourri. I'm the potpourri carpet deodorizer with genuine Arm & Hammer baking soda to absorb odors naturally and make the carpet potpourri fresh.
And I'm the only air freshener with Arm & Hammer baking soda, so I naturally destroy tough bathroom odors and make the air potpourri fresh.
I freshen the carpet.
And I freshen the air.
Natural freshness
from the baking soda experts.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel there are songs to be sung. And every time I see your ring.
Promise bread has no cholesterol and is lower in saturated fats and leading margarines.
You make me feel so young.
Promise. Get heart smart.
I'm Bill Butel. At first, they were condemned for using too much force. Now, Los Angeles police officers are in hot water for not using enough of it. Tonight, we're going to show you a side of the deadly riots you might find hard to believe. And you'd better think twice about parking in a no-parking zone. In a special report, see how your car may be towed, wrecked, ripped off. Next on Eyewitness News.
Later tonight, we will talk about men and sex and rape. An ABC News forum. We hope you'll join us here in West Palm Beach.
Video cassette version of Men, Sex, and Rape, use your Visa or MasterCard and call 1-800-ABC-7500. The cost is $19.98 plus $3.95 shipping and handling. For a transcript, please send $5 to Peter Jennings Reporting, Men, Sex, and Rape, Journal Graphics, 1535 Grant Street, Denver, Colorado, 80203.
This has been a special presentation of ABC News. More Americans get their news from ABC News than from any other source.
America is watching ABC.